Welcome to the Social Media Church Podcast. I'm Neil Smith, and I'm joined by a hero of mine in the church technology space, Bob Pritchett, who is the co-founder and CEO of FaithLife. Bob, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
I would love, as we jump into this, if you would give a little background on yourself and FaithLife, how it all started and what where you are today as a company.
Well, it actually started with going to Christian schools and taking Bible class 5 days a week and hating using Strong's Concordance. So that big, heavy book you look up every word in the Bible in, I didn't like that. And I was a technology geek as a kid. And so when I found out there was a thing called Bible software, I got really intrigued by that. And that was back in the very old days. But it was very immature. And so in high school, I ended up writing my own Bible software.
Wow.
And that led to a mailing list, which led to a project a few years later in college. And then we started the company to distribute the Bible software, Logos Bible software for Microsoft Windows. And I'm still here 28 years after that.
So 28 years ago, Logos was, and there's always the debate among pastors. How do you say Logos?
Apparently it depends on which seminary you went to. So it's Logos, it's Logos, it's we'll answer to any of them.
Got it. Very good. And then so 28 years later, what's happened since that launch of offering the software to pastors and churches to where you are today as a company?
Well, really, it's been a great journey. We've been serving pastors for so long, and everybody who studies the Bible, seminary students, people at home, you know, Sunday school teachers. But over the years, we've started moving from just serving the pastor for Bible study and sermon prep into all the other things the church does. So our Proclaim software runs the screen with Bible verses and song lyrics and sermon notes on the screens. Now we offer live streaming, online giving, church website hosting, and then it's all built around this FaithLife platform, which is really a social connection for your church. But unlike, you know, it's a lot like Facebook, except it has support for prayer requests and private communities and getting messaging and newsletters out to your congregation, whether they're on the platform or not.
Love it. And so the churches that you see that are using your technology the best, what does that look like? How do you see people leaning into the technology effectively?
So we're building what we think is the first truly integrated ministry platform, where we don't just have church management, which is really like a database, you know, names and addresses, but we're taking church management and linking that up to content. So you can buy one solution that lets you communicate with the congregation. It helps you prepare a sermon, present the sermon, archive the sermon online, get the sermon onto your church website without having to touch it, which is a big hassle every week for churches.
Yep.
And then it also includes like a lightweight version of the Bible software for every single person in the congregation, a video library at FaithLife TV that you run on your Roku or your Apple TV. So you can sit in your living room and watch Bible education or faith-friendly videos for your kids. So it's really about what's new is this idea of complete integration. And churches, I mean, right now with coronavirus, churches are seeing the need for that, right? You count on being able to get together every week, and now you can't. So how do you keep people connected? And not just, you know, sending them an email, but how do you keep them connected in doing Bible study together or learning?
Yeah. And so let's talk about coronavirus and what FaithLife is doing now. So I know there's the site faithlife.com/coronavirus where you kind of pulled together a bunch of resources. Can you talk about that and what you're offering there for churches?
Yeah. I mean, we're about 400 people. And so we've got lots of teams working in different areas, and we got a live streaming product up and launched. We are working, you know, our academic team's working on supporting seminaries with curriculum and resources to help people finish seminary semesters remotely. So if you go to that faithlife.com/coronavirus, we've got sections for resources for churches, pastors, just families or home with the kids. Like, you know, do I want to set the kids in front of YouTube or Netflix all week? Well, how about, you know, faith-friendly content like Bible Agent 7 or something like that, as well as seminaries.
I love it. I love it. And and this is obviously not a just about selling FaithLife. I am a big fan, Bob, of yours and how you've led innovation and technology in the church space and around Bible engagement for so many years. I remember my first introduction was with the Logos software. I went to Rockbridge Seminary, and we used it heavily through that online seminary experience. And you've continued to serve the church effectively. And I think one of the things that I appreciate, very efficiently, your software is very affordable. Can you maybe talk about kind of the price structure and because I do love the turnkey of you can do your online giving, your website, your social engagement, your Bible engagement, your content. I mean, it's all there. Right. What does it cost?
Well, you know, actually Logos Bible Software starts at free, right? We give away like 30 books and Bible study resources. You can go to your app store and just download the Logos Bible app on your phone. And it's on the web at logos.com. But what people buy is more content, right? The more you get excited about the Bible study, you want to add commentaries and reference books. So we sell different collections and libraries of books. And some people just use Faith Life TV for like, you know, I don't know, I think it's $5 or $7 a month. And you get tons of Bible education and, you know, Christian video content delivered. But the Faith Life Equip, the strategy we're taking there is to do an all-in-one bundle that includes Bible software for the pastor, Bible software for and Faith Life TV for the entire congregation and everything, church website hosting, giving, communications, messaging. So many products are like nickel and dime you, right? It's like a, you know, there's a taxi meter drops for, oh, you want to add our room scheduling? Oh, you want to add this? You want to add this? It just adds up.
Yep.
And we thought churches don't need that, right? You want it to be simple. So all of our stuff is tried. We tier it basically on small, medium, and large churches because we want to help the smaller churches as much as we can. By making it accessible to them. And we, you know, we got to stay in business, but we try to make things as affordable as possible because we're serving people who are, you know, getting their funds from the offerings in their congregation.
Yeah, I love it. And I would say the majority of the churches that listen to this are large churches, but I am often encouraged by the smaller churches that are also engaged and shocked by how many people I'm talking to right now that didn't even have online giving yet set up and having to figure that out. For those that are jumping into everybody's in a scramble. And even I was talking to a pastor this morning who's had an online campus for 5 years and they're scrambling, you know, and they've been focused on building this online engagement. What, for churches that are jumping in right now, what is it? It feels like technology is overwhelming for people to jump into it. What do you see as the first step? How does somebody, we're kind of in this crawl, walk, run, but we've got to run right away. So how does somebody ease their way in yet sprint at the same time?
Well, I think it's different for every church. It depends on their level of comfort and what they've got set up. Obviously, if you don't have a website, you want to set that up. And Faith Life Sites makes that super easy to do quickly. In fact, you can do it for free if you run it at the subdomain. It takes, you know, 3 minutes to put up your church website. And then you got to start, you know, you make sure you've got a way to reach people, right? If they're not going to show up on Sunday morning in person, can you email them? Can you communicate? Faith Life has a social platform. It's very familiar. If you know how to use Facebook or LinkedIn, it works like that, but it adds live messaging. It has one button initiation of live chatting. I mean, you and I have Zoom downloaded and have installed that and everything, but we've got a live chat that just runs in browsers. So you can just press a button and live chat with your small group without having to worry about, you know, does Mary know how to download, you know, Zoom and install it and all that stuff. So we're trying to make it as easy as possible to onboard training videos. You know, we just shot one of our guys actually at home shot a video on how to set up streaming, right? You know, you take this device you buy on Amazon, you plug the HDMI cable in here. Here's how you hook it up. And that's what our customer success team is doing. I don't know if you've seen the photo of our church support center.
No.
Yeah, we have it. It's on our website. It looks like Mission Control.
Okay.
You know, it's a basement room with 12 flat screen TVs on the wall. And we got people in there 365 days a year supporting churches. They're there every day, including Sunday morning. Generally, they're not needed, which is good. You don't really want to have to call support. But if you need to, we're there. And I know our team has been working weekends and long hours to just handhold people through that. How do I get going process?
I love it. And I'm curious, what are you guys seeing? And I'm sure you're tracking some of the just traffic and engagement over the last couple of weeks. Are you seeing a 100% increase, a 20% increase? What are you seeing right now from an engagement standpoint with these churches?
Churches signing up for online giving is up 20x.
20x.
20x day-to-day signups.
Wow.
Right? Wow. So, you know, that's enormous.
Yes.
Churches signing up for websites. I don't know. In just a few days, we had like 170 new church websites spun up.
Awesome.
So it's they're hitting from all different areas. Yes. And we're still rolling out the whole faith life kind of church management thing. It, yep. You know, the coronavirus, it would have been convenient for us about 3 weeks later, but but we already had hundreds of churches in early access on that, and we are just putting the final touches on it so we can take it out to everybody. It's at equip.faithlife.com, and that demonstrates the whole thing. But yeah, it's just, it's been chaotic, but in a great way, because we're doing what we want to do, which is helping churches.
Yeah. And how many churches now are integrated into the Faith Life community in one way or another at this point?
Well, you know, through Logos Bible software, almost all of them, right? Yeah. I mean, the number of pastors who use Logos is run by tens of thousands of people every day around Logos Bible software. Yeah. We know that over 13,000 churches use Proclaim every weekend to present their slides, their song lyrics, their sermon notes. There's almost 6 million people with a Faith Life account. So using Logos Bible software, using our free Faith Life Study Bible app. So it's a large section of the church.
That's all. And is it global, your engagement?
Absolutely. We have been global since the very beginning. We always wanted to be international, because the U.S. has so many resources, and overseas churches, I mean, the markets are too small. They don't have the local technology support.
That's awesome.
So we have Logos Bible software fully localized in Spanish, Portuguese, German, Chinese, and Korean, in addition to English.
Man, I love it. I love it. Well, as we wrap up this conversation and point people in the right direction, you can go to socialmedia.church. We'll have the links there for you to go to those sites. But Bob, is there any additional advice or encouragement you would give to pastors in this season and ministry leaders?
I just want to give encouragement, right? I know that churches are providing that support that people need and reaching out to their congregants. You know, some of whom are not familiar with this idea of not showing up. I mean, it's been a century since the church couldn't assemble on Sunday, right? Back to the Spanish flu. And so we appreciate the people who are on the front lines serving people through the crisis, and we just want to be supportive.
Awesome. I love it. Bob, thank you for how you've served the church so well for so many years, and how you're serving the church effectively in this moment. This is a critical moment for the church and in the community. And what I love is Faith Life makes the technology simple and affordable for pastors and ministry leaders to serve their communities and focus on the ministry that you're called to. So Bob, thank you for all you do. And thank you for taking the time to join the podcast today.
Thanks. Glad to be here.